all of us have motivation naman, which is actually true. But the problem is, may mga roadblocks tayo in achieving our motivation. So apologies for the train passing by. So going back to the, narinig ko kasi.
Hello mga
Hello everyone.
Ka? Ayan, kamusta Adriel?
Okay naman dito sa Singapore. Medyo malamig dahil umuulan. Chine-check ko kung umuulan pa. Pero umuulan pa rin.
Actually, I think mayroon ding bagyo nga lately.
Dito, dito ano lang, habagat. Yung natural occurrence of rain. Diba kasi yung rain dito sa Singapore eh. Kung yung ulan sa Pinas, yung medyo pang drizzle lang or medyo medium no level. Dito parang bumabagyo yung ulan minsan. So, okay.
Alam pa sa Singapore, medyo humid. Every time na nandyan ako.
Humid talaga. So, anyway, hindi topic natin yung weather ng Singapore. No? So, happy Mental Health Day to everyone out there. And maganda yung topic natin ngayon, no, for Mental Health Day, which would be psychological tips to be a better investor.
Alright. Sige, maganda ito. So, may, I think may mga prepare ka, no, ng mga tips.
Yes.
Oo. Mm-hmm. Ano ba yung mga suggestions or mga advice natin kung paano sila magiging mas magaling na investor?
Yes. So, the first thing, no, is to remove the roadblocks to your motivation. So, I just learned this from a YouTube not psychiatrist, but somewhat like a psychologist. Yeah, behavioral psychologist, like professor from Harvard University. So his channel is actually called The Healthy Gamer. And he discussed that all of us have motivation naman, which is actually true. But the problem is, may mga roadblocks tayo in achieving our motivation. So apologies for the train passing by.
But going back to the,
narinig ko kasi. So going back to the topic, no? So all of us have motivation and sometimes hindi tayo nagiging motivated dahil hindi naman dahil hindi natin makamit pero dahil mayroon there's something stopping us to get to our motivation. So what he suggested was to remove those roadblocks to achieving or let's say going like to stay motivated because motivation is actually more internal than external. So one of the ways to remove those roadblocks is to understand why those roadblocks are there in the first place. And second is to identify what's stopping you from being demotivated or stopping you to, let's say, be motivated, no? So one of the things that he suggested is to, like, say sorry to your past or say sorry to your friends na you've hurt in the past because sometimes yung mga small things na ganun stucks in your mind, eh, stucks in your ego. Your subconscious.
Parang so, trauma, no? Ganun ba
yun? Parang trauma. So, dealing with the past or keeping, let's say, making amends to what you've done in the past helps you remove those roadblocks to attaining self-motivation. So, another thing that you can do is you can write down in a journal, which actually we've been talking, no, in our previous psychological videos, no, what you are grateful for. And focus kung ano yung nagiging grateful ka. And at the same time, take note din on things you are not grateful or things that you need to make up for. So the reason why he also mentioned yung negativity is because minsan kasi yung negativity controls us eh. And that negativity sometimes becomes a roadblock to become more motivated. So that's why identifying those key negativity moments in our life and of course resolving them would eventually lead us to be motivated. And of course, this would also lead you to be more motivated in investing or whatever. So general advice, yung tip number one.
So akong naisip ko dyan, may kaibigan kasi ako, ayaw niya mag-invest. Mas safe para sa kanya na nasa bangko lang yung pera. And of course, lagi ko siya kinukonvince na mag-invest ka kasi nga talo ka sa inflation and all of those reasons. And ang na-discover ko was nung childhood niya, medyo struggling sila as a family, and over, naririnig niya dun sa nanay niya na pag nagkatrabaho ka na, always save, always keep your money safe in the bank, etc. Tapos there was an incident na they tried to invest yung tatay niya, tapos it turned out na scam pala yung napag-investan nung tatay niya. So, medyo nagkaroon ng traumatic experience, kaya
yeah,
ayaw niya mag-invest. And I think, sabi ko sa kanya, one way that you can overcome that quote-unquote trauma is to educate yourself. And if you need help, sabi ko na lang sa kanya, if you need help in understanding how a specific investment works, I can be here to explain it to you so that you'll realize na there are safe options and not all investments are scam. So medyo nagkaroon siya ng ganong mindset.
Or no? Frame of mind, yeah. Or frame of
yes.
Thinking.
So, yun yung roadblock niya. Kaya wala siyang motivation mag-invest. Kasi takot siya mag-invest because of a previous experience nung bata siya. So, I guess that's a great first tip.
Yeah. Yeah. So, moving to number two, which is actually related, no? So, tip number one is don't invest when you're very emotional. Because, again, the stock market in itself is already an emotional roller coaster, no? So, up and down siya. And if you're emotional, let's say galit ka or nalulungkot ka or whatever, no, what you're feeling right now na valid, don't invest or don't look into your stock chart or kung anong mutual fund growth or whatever statistics yan, because baka mainganyo ka to put more money or to withdraw it kahit hindi naman necessary, no. So what you can do instead is to release the emotion, or I'm not a psychiatrist or psychologist, but just to like give those emotions some thought, or like pansinin nyo naman yung emotion nyo. And then once na mas stable na kayo, let's say mas in a better mood compared to before, doon na kayo mag-invest because you're more rational and then you can make better decisions that way. And of course, better investing decisions, no? Lahat naman tayo gusto mo, no? Makapera, so gawin din natin ng konting effort sa sarili natin na we get to that point na we earn more money. And being emotional, too emotional actually, won't help us in getting or achieving our financial goals.
Mm-hmm. And I remember yung nabasa ko sa isang behavioral economics na libro na meron tayong System 1 and System 2, di ba?
Ah, Thinking Fast, Thinking Slow ba ito?
Oo, ni si Daniel Kahneman.
No? So yung system, yan.
Yeah, yung System 1, yun yung instinct. So ito yung ginagamit natin na survival instinct na pag may nakita tayong leon, tatakbo tayo. Alam mo, kasi
yung mga fight or flight instinct natin.
Yes. Tapos yung System 2, yun yung mas rational and logical. So what you're saying is, pag meron tayong heightened emotional state, like sobrang masaya or sobrang galit, di ba?
Yeah.
Baka ang magamit natin sa ating investment decisions ay yung System 1 natin. So it's always best to lower our baseline, be calm, so that we can properly use yung System 2 natin, yung more rational thinking natin, especially when making investment decision. So, yun lang yung nakuha ko dun sa sinabi mo, Adriel, no? Tama.
Yeah, and just to add, no, quickly, minsan kasi connected yung System 1 and System 2 natin, eh. So, kapag heightened yung System 1, minsan dinoloko na niya yung System 2. Kaya kailangan na i-calm down si System 1 bago natin gamitin yung System 2. Dahil flight or fight response kasi si System 1. So kapag mas grabe yung flight or fight response, mag-e-effect talaga yan sa investing decisions natin.
Mm-hmm. Kaya may mga tao na nakitang bumagsak yung stock market, biglang ibebenta yung investment nila ng palugi kasi natakot, nagpanic, fear set in without really thinking na this was just a correction, alam mo yon, a short-term move, and dahil long-term investment sila, they just need to be patient. So yung more rational or more logical explanation of what they should do next, nakakalimutan kasi na-cloud na sila nung fear, nung emotion of fear nung nakita nila bumagsak. Kaya kailangan they also have to be aware nung kanilang state of mind na ano ba ako? Am I feeling fearful or angry or even happy, di ba? Basta any strong emotion, kailangan medyo i-control natin, go lower our baseline to a point na kalmado tayo so that we can properly use yung rational natin and yung logic natin when making investment decisions. Yun.
Yes. And that leads now to tip number three, which is actually just don't look at the stock market every day. Though unless trader ka, of course, kailangan mong makita yung stock market every day. Pero kung, let's say, passive investor ka, don't look at it every day. Kahit once or twice a week, or depende sa investment style mo, pwede na once a month or twice a month. No? So depending on your tolerance, you can ignore or do tip number three, but the logic behind this is connected to tip number two, no? Kapag kasi nakikita natin yung stock market everyday, sumasali tayo sa emotion ng stock market na up and down. So yung emotions din natin nagiging up and down. So sometimes it would lead, no, to what you just said, to panic buying or panic selling or mga moments where iniisip na kailangan ko na ba mag-invest or should I withdraw? So again,
mag-overthink
mag-overthink tayo. So to avoid overthinking, always remember, no, why you invested in the first place, which is actually tip number four. Mm-hmm. And of course, always remember, when you invest, this is a long game, especially when you're doing yung fundamental analysis or yung passive investing, na parati talaga may up and down sa stock market. And it's always a good thing to put in when it's low and of course sell when it's high. But then again, contextualize where you are now. Baka kasi nag-invest ka pero yung pera na kailangan, no, sorry, yung pera na invest mo, kailangan mo pala bumili for a gift for your loved one or sa jowa mo, or kailangan pala to pay for a medical bill na kailangan mo. So again, be careful, no, when looking at the stock market every day.
Ako ang ginagawa ko, meron akong, I check the news, the business news, to see kung merong balita dun sa mga companies sa portfolio ko. Kung wala, then okay lang. And kung meron, I will check if it has any effect on the stock price. Ngayon, kung wala, then okay lang. Ignore. I just let it pass. But my portfolio itself, I usually check it once a month. Kasi ano, tinatrack ko, ano, inaano ko siya, dinodocument ko ano yung mga price movements niya pagdating sa portfolio ko. Pero yun lang, no, once a month, tapos quarterly, usually I do a quick evaluation na okay pa ba to. Ang pinaka analysis ko dun sa stock portfolio ko, annual, usually end of the year, I decide if I should continue or if I should buy a new company, is there a better opportunity? So yung mga ganong klaseng analysis, once a year ko lang siya ginagawa. Yung quarterly, it's just a quick evaluation na okay pa ba o hindi, kamusta siya during the past quarter, etc. Pero yung monthly, it's just me documenting the price. I don't even try to look at the charts. Mas aware, mas binabasa ko or mas pinapanood ko yung news. So, for example, Jollibee. I have Jollibee as my long-term investment. So, ang mas tinitingnan ko yung balita rather than the price. And so far, puro good news ang Jollibee. They're expanding, etc. So, that means there's no need for me to check my stock portfolio or the price of Jollibee kasi alam ko na earnings, the price of the stock will follow the earnings. So if Jollibee continues to expand and earn more, then I'm pretty sure the stock price will also go up. So ganun na lang. And sayang din kasi yung oras. At saka yun nga, I don't want to overthink pag titignan ko yung stock portfolio ko eh. Yun.
Yeah. So I mentioned earlier no, tip number 4, which is remember why you invested in the first place. So just to like summarize everything, ito yung groundwork mo when you're investing. So in case no, you'd be emotional, nalilito ka na on what to do, always remember why you invested in the stock market in the first place. Because remembering that why would help you stay grounded and would also make you more rational when it comes to doing investing. Because parating natatalo yung taong na sobrang emotional when it comes to stock market investing or trading. So another thing here is that kapag may mga chismis, no, naririnig ka, tapos kung na-remember mo yung why mo in investing, you would immediately think, itong chismis ba applicable sa portfolio ko? Or natapos na ba yung chismis na to? Because kapag naiganyo ka or naniwala ka bigla sa chismis na yan, baka kasi biglang nag-pull out ka or nag-put in ka more money kahit tapos na yung chismis or nakikisama ka lang sa hype. So, tama. That's tip number 4.
Alright, so I hope marami kayong natutunan, mga ka-RK, dito sa ating video. So, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and then share it to your friends. And please remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Yes, and if you want more psychological tips, videos here no in the right or left, mga ganito. Somewhere here in the video.
Lalagyan ni Adriel ng, ng card, no? Yes, and of course, happy mental health month ba or day?
Day actually or week?
Day.
I forgot na the term. I know, alam ko mental health day. So happy mental health day everyone and stay healthy, keep safe and see you guys on the next video. Bye-bye.
Okay, bye-bye.